Today I'm going to teach you how to address people. There are two words you need to know. Khanom, khanom, which means miss, miss, missus, or lady. And aqa, which means mister or sir. Okay, how do we use these words? There is an easy rule, all right? So please pay attention. If you're going to use the person's first name, you will have to use these titles after the person's first name. All right, so the rule is first name first, then the title. Okay, for example, my name is Tina. My first name is Tina. So if someone wants to address me using these titles, any of these titles, in order to show respect, but at the same time they don't want to be too formal with me, they can refer to me as Tina Khanom. Right? So they are putting the title Khanom after my name. Now, imagine if they want to talk to a guy. They would refer to a guy by using the title Aqa. Okay, so the word Aqa again will come after the first name of the guy. So imagine if the guy's name is Ali, you would refer to him as Ali Aqa. Okay, now if you need to be ultra formal with people, which means you will need to use their last names, what you will do is you will put exactly the same titles, you will use exactly the same titles before their last name. And you need to add e or ye. I'm going to show you how. Okay, my last name is Rahimi. If someone wants to be ultra formal with me, they can refer to me as Khanom Rahimi. So here the title Khanom has come before the name. However, we also need a Khanom Rahimi. Okay, imagine your last name is Johnson. If someone, an Iranian friend, wants to refer to you in an ultra formal way, they would refer to you as Aqay Johnson. Aqay Johnson. If, of course, you're a guy. If you're a girl, you would be Khanom Johnson. Khanom Johnson. Okay, now, again, we need to put the connector e or ye after the words Khanom and Aqa. However, you may ask me, why do we need a different connector? Why can't just we use e in both cases? Well, the answer is purely phonetic. The reason is the word Aqa ends in a vowel a. Therefore, putting e after it would make it sound a little awkward, no? Aqa e, not that smooth. That is why we would replace e with ye anytime we need to use the connector after a word which ends in a vowel, like the word aqa. Okay, now, there's a little test for you. You can tell me how you would be referred to in Farsi, both on a formal and informal level using these titles. Leave your feedback in the comments below and I would be happy to get back to you. In case there's anything wrong, or in case you have got it right, and I just want to say, Afarin, which means bravo. Until the next class, khodafez.